Harvard University was looking for a new president, and they narrowed it down to three people. One was an accountant, one was a mathematician, and one was a lawyer. So they came in and brought the accountant in first, and they said, "How much is one plus one?" The accountant said, "You brought me here for this." He said, "It's two, of course." And he left. Then they next brought in the mathematician, and they said, "How much is one plus one?" So he said, "Well, in the short order, it's either plus two or minus two, depending on which universe you're dealing in." So they said, "Okay, that's a good start." So then the lawyer came in his three-piece suit, and they said to the lawyer, they said, "How much is one plus one?" Blair didn't answer. Instead, he got out of his chair. He went to all the windows, closed them. He locked the door. He sat down again, and he whispered across, and he said, "How much do you want it to be?"
And he wanted to escape. So they had a plan. Lynn was going to punch the guard. Lucinda was going to get the keys. And Angie was going to get the supplies. So the next day, Lynn punched the guard. Lucinda got the keys. And Angie? You're supposed to get the supplies, not the surprise.
Cái câu chuyện này hồi xưa có ở Việt Nam, một cái chùa nó rất là lớn và rất là nổi tiếng, mà ai vô đó thì được cái giấy không có được đi lính. Cái chùa Vĩnh Nghiêm nằm ngay đường nhà công Trình Công Lý á, mà ba cái ông sư này thì ông này không phải là sư, mà họ là cái người mà không có đi lính, là họ trốn luôn thôi chứ phải là sư. Thì chúng mình kêu là sư thôi, nhưng ông có sư không phải là sư. Thì vô trong đó thì được cái giấy không có đi lính, mà ba ông này là người Nam, thành thử họ tụng kinh tiếng Nam không à. Thì lúc vô đó thì ban ngày á thì họ mặc áo vàng, thì ban đêm đó họ đi ra, họ đi ăn xuống mì, xuống chợ cũ ăn mì lai cai. Thì lúc giải phóng vô á, giải cổng vô á, thì cái chùa không có còn là chùa nữa, thử làm cái chỗ mà nuôi gà cả nuôi heo, thử nó tống ba ông sư đi về kinh tế mới luôn. Thì được ba ông sư xuống đó thì không biết làm gì sống hết trơn á, thì mấy ông chuyên môn đi lừa người ta không à. Thử thì cái ông ba ông sư ông đi chỉnh cái đê đó thì ông gặp trong sự thứ nhất á, ông áo vàng ông đi ông nói là Nam Mô Di Bồ Tát nào chính xác được cái khúc giữa đường. Rồi ông nói cho cái ông thứ hai á, chuẩn bị đi. Cái ông thứ hai ông nói là cái bát đại kim cang cái đúng cành càng sao vác nổi. Thì ông nói ông thứ hai cái khúc nó bự quá làm sao mà khiên. Cái ông kia thì ông bán chạy trời quen rồi, nó thật bát là hắn tháo cái cán bỏ đi lấy cái lưỡi bỏ túi. Cái người thứ hai chạy trời bán.
打坐以后就会减少一点，蛮有聪明，不做聪明，学习什么比较快啊？反应比较快，还有我们如果打坐多的话，大家一起打坐就世界会多一点那个快乐了啊！这几个礼拜啊，你们这个中心打坐很多，要多一点啊！OK，问男孩子嘛，做多一点有什么关系？利益别人啊！ 随便的，坐在那边的啊，坐到死为止，看看会不会死呀。还有
不好意思哈，因为师傅，因为像因为我们两个是姐弟这样，那因为我妈妈他们也，我妈妈她也异性的，所以有的时候比如说我们打坐打不够啊，或者是说就是比较偷懒的时候，我妈妈他们就她就会比较着急，所以就可能有时候会比较生气这样子，所以就变成说她压力会比较大，会觉得就越来越生气，越骂她，她就越不想打坐，就会越 upset 这样子，然后就不想修行，要退心这样，常常就是有这种问题。所以其实我自己也是，我自己常常也是会很偷懒，然后做都没有打好，然后再就是可能因为我20岁嘛，所以可能想世界的事情也是比较多这样子，是大概就是我们两个很大的问题。可是每次看完师傅之后回去又会因为很好这样子，然后过一阵子又不行了。
我也有一个问题啊，就是想请教你们两个啊，如果你们是妈妈的话，那你们怎么做啊？
对啊，
那你们随便偷懒或是鼓励鼓励这样啊？如果你当妈妈，你怎么做？
也是很着急。
对，因为他知道那个是对你们
好的，
他才这样讲。不过也许他讲的方法不适合你们的口味，哎，不过他也没办法嘛，他做他的最好的啊，然后你们也认为你们只能做你们的最好的。大家也尽量做了，不过我们有时候年纪不一样啊，啊，经验的世界的经验不一样啊，啊，痛苦的程度不一样啊，
对，
担忧的啊 ，business 啊，工作啊不一样，所以妈妈有很多压力，懂吗？妈妈比较老了，啊，时间不多了，她知道她随时就走了，然后她世界的那个经验也很多，经过很多痛苦啊，懂吗？所以她就想不想你们。
长
大了，就跟他一样那么痛苦。
反而我们自己觉得好像世界还很美好啊，
当然啦、
啊，然后没无忧无虑这样过生活。
当然，那什么都妈妈做了，你还做什么？什么忧虑都妈妈在承担了，所以你们不知道了，懂吗？然后妈妈又不想你们长大了，跟他一样这样子糊糊涂涂过了一生啊，到现在才晓得，懂吗？所以他就。急一点，让你们多聪明，多那个独立啊，多了解智慧啊，让他万一他随时走的时候，随时他死了，那你们就不会那个太无助啊，听懂吗？应该了解妈妈的心。哎，我知道我妈妈讲话不是随时好听的，我们小孩子不喜欢听父母那么多了，因为他们都用那个在用父母的那种。口气嘛，你该做了，不该做都会怎么样怎么样了，然后我们小的时候都爱玩啊，爱乐啊，没什么这么急干什么呢？我就有10几岁啊，20岁，急什么嘛，懂吗？所以我们两个想法不一样。
还有，
以后妈妈讲的话，就多想一点，她的那个年纪啊，她的经验啊，她的背景啊，她的忧虑不一样。这样子就会减小了你们那种生气的心了啊！如果他讲话是太呀，比方说太那个太急的，就跟他说了，说妈妈你讲柔一点，我就做了，这样就 OK 了啊！大家商量 ，OK。
因为我跟我妈妈之间的关系比较特别，慢慢渐渐的，现在开始我就觉得说我没有办法跟她生活在一起这样，可是她又心里就觉得我这样越不孝顺，觉得我们没有办法融合在一起，就是说，然后我就越来越觉得她要求我的这种，我知道我自己很不对，在这个位置我晓得，可是我又没有办法克服在她面前那种很紧张那种压力，就是不敢表现自己内在一些感受的那种感觉。
不会了，不会了。他太苦了，
对，我知道他
太苦了。然后，你们两位，即使有多爱他，也不会完全能够弥补他那个苦衷的心。如果你们两位能忍耐、忍爱他的话，每次多抱一点就好了。从外面回来就抱一下，不讲也没关系，抱他就知道了。能抱多久就多久啊，因为有时候很害羞，不能讲说我爱你妈妈，不能讲就算了，
啊，要写下来也可以啊。
像现在情况都已经变成他已经知道我对他的感情不深的那样子。
哎呀，没关系，你现在重新开始嘛。好，现在有一个办法，就是以后哈，如果你不能跟他讲话，你就把他写一封信，啊，放在他枕头那里，他慢慢自己看。你把你内在的全部的感觉写下来 ，OK， 啊，尽量写呢，用那种柔软的那个字啊。有时候我们表达感情，如果我们用字比较硬的话，就不一样，而且两个那个斗口的时候没办法共事了 ，OK，
对对对。
那你、你们
磨错碎啊，
是啊，啊，越讲越麻烦了、啊，
对对对对，
每一个都多讲几句就麻烦，
然后就增加印象，
当然啊，对对，然后天天都是重复那种
对对对
那种否定的那种体验的话，当然没办法再重新开始了。好，如果你能够就去一个人在靠他附近，弄一个房子也好，不过最好那么年轻的跟妈妈住一起也好，不过要写信呢、啊，不能讲的写信呢、啊，啊，那天他说我怕讲起来的话，有时候。年轻嘛，我不好控制自己那个口诀啊，所以我把它写下来啊，啊，我怎么想怎么想，每天写那种好的东西啊，即使有坏的东西你忽略它，即使讲出来也没用啊，所以最好就找他的好的东西讲出来写下来 ，OK， 每天写几句也好，不用写很多，不是每天写啦，你想爱他的时候你就写下来，你想不爱他的时候不要写，啊，那你先写信吧。看看有没有情况好一点啊？如果没好，再写信给师傅，我们再想别的办法。
好
，OK。
好，
如果我碰到你妈妈，我还跟她再讲几句。
好
，OK。
好，谢谢师傅。
要偶尔买一点什么小东西送给她，嗯，这样子，即使她生气的话，那看你那么努力要进步那个情况啊，她也会感动，也会在自己在想，那、每个人进一步嘛。OK， 然后你做好了以后，他就会觉得惭愧，然后他也自己做好，那两个一起越做越好，就把那个坏的过去就会盖掉了，不然的话没办法。那以后你就把握他的手嘛，坐在那边啊，
就尽量安抚他这样。
对啊，头低低的、啊、说完对不起，我就年轻不知道怎么说，啊，这样子。不过我很喜欢了解你那个痛苦的心，就是我还没有经验啊。你说因为你爱护我们太好了，我们没办法受苦过，因为是你的爱太多了，你照顾我们太周到了，所以我们没办法感觉到你那个痛苦啊。啊，你跟他开玩笑，你说都是妈妈的错啊，谁叫你爱我们这么多？OK， 不要太严肃了，两个都严肃就死在一起啊。啊，想办法嘛。啊，哎，不是带他去玩啊，啊。带他就去看电视、看电影，什么好好的、好玩的。
我妈妈说不可以出去看电影，
啊、可以可以，
因为外面人太多，会一堆夜唱全部包回家。
哎呀，不会啦，偶尔带他去玩一玩 ，OK。
OK，
偶尔啦，不是天天。
他不喜欢到人多的地方去。
哎呀，那他就不喜欢在家里，也不喜欢出去。
没有，他喜欢在家里，因为他可能比较敏感一点。
好，那你做一部什么好玩的电影，大家一起看。
好，
买 popcorn 什么一起吃。OK。哎，就有一种家庭的暖和的，妈妈她太严重了，她太苦了，她想不通了。啊，你们年轻人就会有一些概念啊，怎么玩啊，就跟她一起啊，啊，让她知道你关心。
不是硬心之后，我们就完全通通待在家里面打坐什么什么，就是因为感觉上我妈都说好像。就是阴性之后，就是修行，就是不要去接触一些音，就是那种阿修罗的那种音乐啊，或者说太有看电影看太多，就会被他们所影响，就会整个掉下来。
不会，有一些电影它有那种教育性啊，你不要通通都看了、啊，那些暴力那种太复杂的那都不要看啊。不，有一些很好玩的，也可以开心一点啊。有一些又好玩又有一种教训的那种。那种啊，怎么样品质啊，我也常常看了、啊、哎，你们看电影的时候就想看这部电影能教我一些什么东西啊，如果坏的话当然不要弄这样子，就知道这个是坏了啊，自己要学习一下，懂吗？哎，那跟他解释了，说这部电影很好啊，因为这里面要教小孩孝顺怎么弄怎么弄啊，不是在我们在乎爱护动物怎么样怎么样啊，不是家庭里面啊有问题的话怎么解决怎么解决，都有很多电影里有一些教训的部分，哎，要选的好，
来 ，OK， 好，那我也许我要给你们一个 list， 什么电影可以看这样，建议的好不好？
好
，OK， 下一次，下一个假次会有。
好
好。好呀，那那那瓜就
滚。你 OK， 走吧。
công an sư phụ là thì ở Hàm Công á, truyền pháp là năm 92 mà ngày 26 tháng 29 là khi sư phụ cô ở Hàm Công ở chợ A Lây á, mà bây giờ con về tiếp xúc mới qua đã là từng đó mà vì nhà sư phụ nhưng mà cũng không có phương tiện là đi thăm sư phụ, bây giờ không ai lại không biết cách thế nào. Cũng nhờ sư phụ chứ còn nếu mà không không có sư phụ mà ái thì cũng gia đình con chết cũng đi được. Ai có nói này không? Hết được. Thì hôm nay gặp ở đây sư phụ đây, mà trước cũng trả công ơn sư phụ là vì vấn đề ở trại gian khổ quá mà sư phụ cũng nhất mà cũng tinh tấn tu hành. Cho nên hôm nay mới được ngày nay gặp sư phụ thôi. Gia đình con cũng đầu ơn sư phụ.
Cảm ơn.
Không có gì đâu bác. Mừng cho bác hả? Mừng cho bác có gia đình qua được. Wow, what do you have here? Oh yeah, how do you have it together? That's a tiger. Oh, that's my sign. Ý này cái sâu chứ mà là chứ đâu, chứ đâu. Ok, nãy lưu yêu thì đại trông là đông xí. Hả? OK， 你要帮妈妈不要提太重东西啊。啊，顺便告诉你们两位，那个年轻刚才问问题那个还在吗 ？OK， 我告诉你，有一些东西可以让妈妈开心啊。你们回去，我是在家里看到她最喜欢做什么嘛，就帮她忙啊。比如说妈妈买菜回去啊，在门口等她啊，懂不懂？那等你买哈 ，OK。然后他回来没有什么事干啊？哦，这样子好，那就很好了啊。家里有一个人打坐的话，也是蛮不错的，对世界很有帮助啊。你们应该高兴有一个圣人当妈妈。哎呀，古代的时候人家就去拜那些俄罗汉呐、啊，懂不懂啊？哎呀，他自己就一个，太好了。啊，他就喜欢你们修行嘛，就这样子、啊，好了，没关系。那常常弄一杯茶给他，问他累不累，捶一捶啊 ，OK， 看他喜欢什么就做嘛 ，OK， 先做，不要让他问，啊，尽量观察看看妈妈最爱什么，买给他吃，煮给他吃，或是尽量想办法煮给他吃醋。我是看看了、啊，我煮不大好，不过为了你煮啦，等等这样子，那种小小细细的东西啊。很可爱的，就给妈妈高兴，嗯、啊，她就会知道。哎，我们一天到晚说我爱你，我爱你没用啊，应该做一点东西，嗯、啊，跟表达那个用动作表达，嗯、哎，然后晚上她睡觉的时候，比方说你弄一个热被，什么放在她被袋里面啊，让她睡得好啊，比方说这样子，啊，小小东西啊，或是弄菜给妈妈吃啊，啊这样子她就会高兴，有弄。
其实师傅。这些都是我妈妈，她最需要，她每次都是希望有邀请到这些。
对呀、
啊，
你看。
可是我有的时候笨手笨脚，或者说做不好，她好像。有的时候笨手笨脚或做不好的时候，她就会觉得说，就是，对了，每当我做这样子，她就觉得很贴心，很温暖，很高兴。
对呀、啊，那继续做吧。
然后有的，可是我在我就是很烂嘛，所以有的时候就做不好，或者说比较没有这个心啦。嗯、啊。有时候比较自私，就是只想
要
做自己的
事。你要做了。要做。万一妈妈死了以后，就会很后悔呀、啊。而且如果你们多敬爱她的话，哈，她就很高兴温暖，然后家庭你们也会受影响，懂吗？妈妈高兴，你们也会高兴。相信我，真的。如果你多爱她的话。你自己会给感觉的生活更舒服，哎，是有这种连贯呢。你让你妈妈越高兴，你生活越舒服，我保证这样。哎，你越体贴、啊，懂不懂？越尽量做给她高兴的话，你会更高兴。啊，如果不行的话，我就把思维症收回来，让你们
放生啊。
像他每次打电话从台湾回来问我说，弟弟有他要我盯着他嘛，因为他13岁嘛，
嗯，
他有没有打到2.5小时，我每次都不知道怎么回答，因为他都没有打到2.5小时。
他自己以后会回答，
只要他不打到2.5小时都是我在挨骂。
OK，
因为我自己没打2.5小时也是噼啪噼啪
啊。 OK OK， You understand English？
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, you have only 2 choices. It's up to you. You take the responsibility of yourself, be a man, or you let somebody else keep nagging you, kicking you, and then make trouble for you, and take responsibility for your life. Okay? So it's up to you. Huh? If you want to continue hearing her this kind of nagging and scolding and complaining, then you continue doing the way you do. Yeah?And if you want to show her that you've grown up now, you are a responsible man and woman, you know what to do with your life, then show her. Do it. Yeah? And then she has no chance to say anything because you know what to do. You take your own life into your hand and you take responsibility of a grown up person. Then she won't tell you anything. Show her that she no need to tell you because you know how to take care.Of yourself. Just show her. Do that. Okay? Do what you think is correct. There's only 2 ways to do things in this life. The correct thing and the incorrect thing. Yeah? If you do incorrect things, of course, the incorrect consequence will come. And people will know it, will tell you, oh, this is incorrect, this is incorrect. You don't like to hear that. So you do the correct way. You know what is your work? You list it. Okay? This is every day I have to do. Okay? I do this, I do that.And leftover time, you play. You do whatever else you want. Then nobody can say anything but respect. They just show respect to you because, my God, you're so young, but you already take control of your life and know how to discharge your responsibility in a perfect way. And Mama probably would have to learn from you, and she would just praise you. See? You know already what to do. Don't you? Both of you know what to do, right?To make things better, okay? Then either you do it or you let her nag you all your life until you grow up and grow bare up to here. She still continue. So that's your 2 choices. Now you choose, okay? For you grown up people, I don't want to tell you what to do. You know what to do. You know exactly what to do. Just you didn't want to do it. And now it's only one question. Do you want to do it now or you don't? Okay? It's your choice. Your life.You want to make a mess of your life, it's okay with me. You want to make a beautiful life and smooth living with your family and your members, it's fine with me too, because your family, your life, okay? Your time, your nerves. You want to wreck your nerves every time you talk on the phone like that, tell her you what to do like a small kid, or you want to show her that you're a grown-up man or woman, okay? Easy, no? Is it easy? Ah, okay, very easy. Maybe I wasn't as good as the way I talk now when I was a kid. Yeah? So I have hope in you. I put my hope in you that you can do it for me and make up for my youth. In the young time, I also do some foolish thing. Yeah? Because nobody teach me. My parents busy. Yeah? I'm left with a servant. I eat whatever, you know, they feed me, and I didn't want to eat meat. So I don't take care of myself very well. I don't have much guidance. Yeah?But now you have meditation, you are vegetarian, you are yogis. Yeah. You are yogis, a modern yogis. You are in a very, very turbulent world, very tempting world, and you are so young, but you have chosen your way already. Do you know you are a young yogi? You chose to be vegetarian. You choose to keep the 5 precepts, to choose a noble way of life. My God, you're so great.Just a little bit more and you're perfect. Your mother wants you to be perfect. So you go to school. How many kids eat vegetarian and try to meditate like you? Even if you meditate 5 minutes, this is better than 99.9% of the world already. Do you know that? Even adult people don't do that. They couldn't even eat vegetarian. And you have chosen this way to live your life.You know what to do already, okay? No need anybody to tell you what to do. So just do it. Huh? Discipline yourself. No, what you have to do, just do it. Because if you don't do it, people will nag you anyhow, so might as well do it. You don't do it today when you're old, you have to meditate 10 hours a day. You want to do that? Maybe you die tomorrow, you don't have chance. So do it. Huh? Do it just like you breathe. If you don't breathe, you die. Will you stop breathing? Huh? No. Okay. Now, the way you talk to me, your mother keep nagging you like that, it look, and you make... You're so nervous and all that. This is no good for you. No good for your health. It's like you stop breathing or you don't breathe properly. You understand? Suppose if you can't breathe properly, then you find a way to make yourself breathe again, no? Okay, so your life is suffocating right now because you're doing things that according to what you should do, what you know you should do, and then just change it. Yeah? The situation will be better. You don't have to worry about mother anymore if you do everything correctly, you know. You meditate more and you just do it. Even if she nags you, you still feel different. That's her problem now because I'm doing everything perfect. Yeah? Now you're nervous because you know you don't do it. That's why. See what I mean? You don't do it. You don't meditate well.
How do we get away from the pressure from professional need?
Every time you just go meditate, recharge yourself, okay? There's no gain without pain. Any profession have pressure. You ask anybody, they don't have any pressure, even they do a housewife, do they have pressure? Yeah? You write your own kids, are you having pressure or not? Yeah. What do?
I'm a singer.
A singer, do you have pressure or not?
Yes,
big, big pressure, right?
Less pressure than when I worked in medicine, though.
Yeah? Were a doctor or something?
I was a registered nurse for 18 years.
Uh-huh. But it's better now?
The singing.
Yeah?
Yes.
Maybe because it's more artistic. Yeah. But you have also pressure and deadline and show.
Oh, yes.
Show pressure because you have to please the audience and the manager always have to tell you what to do, the coach has coaching you and all kind of thing, just because you can express yourself better than so you feel it's better, that's all.
Yes. Okay.
But you still have pressure, right? Or you don't have pressure?
I still have pressure, I have deadlines.
Yeah, of course.
And there's always the money problem.
Yes, you see that. Wow.
Yes.
That is a big pressure too.
Yes,
even though you don't feel it's a pressure. Yeah, when you were a nurse, the more steady.
That's right.
Yeah. You know how much you gain every day and you know what to do. This is more risky, but you didn't think there's a pressure, that's all, okay?
That's true,
I did. Just a little bit more freedom.
You know what I noticed, though? When I try to get a nursing job for the stability,
yeah,
they don't want me.
Anymore. But,
so the singing is taking over.
Okay, good.
And that's where my heart is, so.
Then okay, do what you like, yeah. So how about your pressure? What kind of pressure? The students give you pressure?
Students' complaints.
Yeah.
Colleagues' competition.
Yeah.
What
kind of teaching you do?
What subject? She and I are teaching.
Oh.
Chinese literature.
Oh. Who is it?
Who's your friend? Where's
your? Okay. How?
So we have the problem of competing in a very vigorous professional field to get our tenure. Because every junior faculty has to go through the evaluation 5 or 6 years before your job can be secured.
Oh.
And teaching evaluation, scholarship, publication.
Oh.
And it's a field which is highly competitive.
Uh-huh.
And a lot of times we are left with no time. Everybody has no time. But there's simply no time to kind of do something more relaxed.
Uh-huh.
And it feel like you are
rushing all the time.
Right. And then I lose patience.
Yeah.
I used to be a very patient person, but I don't think I am anymore.
Too much pressure, huh? How about, do you have a homework to do? Like,
homework?
At home, do you do as a housewife work?
No.
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 Just do your professional work.
Yeah, when you go home, you write, you try to do research, and you try to have publications so you can get your tenureship as a professor. Otherwise, you will lose your job if you don't.
Okay, fine. Do you like this job?
It's enjoyable to a certain extent.
Mm-hmm.
Teaching is
helping. You prefer to do anything else? Never mind about this doctrine about what you should do and what you should not. You prefer to do anything else?
No, in fact, that's the thing I like to do.
Okay, but then continue with that and take the price. Pay the price. Yeah. But okay. What makes you so always in a hurry? Why? Why you don't have time?
There's so much that you have to do to finish. For example, you finish your preparation for a class, take care of the students. You have commitment to publications.
Yes. And you have to read more.
No, Master, you are very busy yourself.
No, I'm not really busy. Look, I'm just sitting here talking. See, I'm busy doing anything?
But when you are busy, do you lose your temper?
I do. I lose it all the time, not even when I'm not busy. No. Of course, when you're busy, you have more pressure, but that's normal, okay? Forgive yourself. If you can, then be cool. If you cannot, then just be yourself. Hold something in your hand, or wear something when you're angry. You lose it.
Hold it.
Yeah, hold it or remind yourself. Squeeze my picture, whatever. Yeah? Oh my God. You couldn't cut out anything that unnecessary? For example, sometimes, you know, like, you teach Chinese literature, okay? You select what is the best only, okay? And don't read any other garbage. Otherwise, you read too much and you take up all of your time. Yeah, you should know by now which one's the best. I choose something more spiritual, more nourishing for the students. Yeah, choose what you like best and do it. And that would be good for them too. Any literature have garbage? Don't you know that? So pick out the best that you enjoy more and that you limit to some subject only. You see what I mean? You don't just read anything. It is difficult, but by the time you will know which one you should select and read for your homework so that you can give out to the student. You understand? Select well. Or if you don't know, or somebody else, recommend, research on the internet or whatever, you know, see which one is the best and the most crispy and most profitable for the student, and you also enjoy. Like this, you don't have to spend a lot of time researching something that is not really fruitful, okay? Like this, you save your time. And you have to read their grade, right? Read their homework, huh? Read fast. You have to learn speed reading. That helps you too, okay? You can read like one book in a few minutes. Yeah, learn that. Yeah, invest some time to learn this. Okay, that will help you tremendously. But you have to read books and you have to read their homework. So learn that. Okay, that will save you a lot of time too. Okay, what else that take up your time?
Competition and sense of insecurity.
No competition with anybody. You do what you do. Okay, and if you lose, you lose. All right, be a good loser. Now, look here, that's what makes problem for you. You want this position too much. Don't want it. Do it for fun. Do it to help the student to gain knowledge. Do it for your self-fulfillment of life. Okay? If you lose the job, you lose it. Forget the job. You don't do it for the job. Okay? You do it to pass your day in a perfect time the way you want it to do. Okay? And if you get that job, that means the judge in your school has wisdom. Okay, whatever, you just do your best, okay? But forget the job, okay? When I do my painting, I don't think I'm going to sell it. I never thought about it. I do whatever I feel like, it's just for me. And that's how it works, okay? You do it for yourself. You do what you want. And if you get the job, fine. If you don't get the job, there's other job to do.
So if you don't
need it too much.
Don't perform well in
No, I tell you to do the best. But forget the job. Don't do it to get the position. Do it for the student's knowledge, for your own fulfillment. Understand? Have fun. Have fun with your job. Forget about the position. If you're doing it just to get the position, you're cheap. I'm sorry. Okay? You don't do it for anything. You do it to help the student to gain the best knowledge that you can offer. Okay? Give them the best that you know. And meanwhile, fulfilling yourself because you're doing the best. You're doing that not for competition. Understand? And that's the best job. Okay? That's the best way to do any job. All right? Don't worry about it, about the position. Thank you. Even the President of the United States, you know how much time they spend on campaign? You know how much millions of dollars they waste every year just to get into the office 4 years only? And they even lose all the money and don't get anything. So your effort is not much to be a governor. It's nothing. Yeah. You even gain money meanwhile, but they lose. See what I mean? They don't even know if they can be president even. And they lost all the money. My God. I feel sorry for all the money. And you didn't doing all this good job for benefit of the younger people. You're doing your best. You're giving what you think is best for them. Understand? And that's how you feel best about yourself. Yeah? And if the world gives you this position, it's fine. It's God's will. If not, you know you do your best already. And that is the best reward. That's your reward. And that's your position in your heart. Okay? Being the best professional. That's all. Okay? Not to get the job or not to gain more money. That's cheap. We're practitioners. We don't think of that. And there's another thing even. You're never sure if you live another day and get that position and this position. Yeah. Lots of the pressure we give ourselves, no? Yeah. Not even sure if you live until tomorrow. Sit here and wait for 5 years I get that professional job. Goodness. What a pressure. Yeah. Most of the pressure we give ourselves. Yeah? Sometimes we cannot help it because we work with other people and they give us pressure for nothing. But if we can control it, you know, we take things in our hand. We do the best, eh? That's it, finito.
Master, I often encounter beggars on the street and they ask for money. And I do not know whether they want to use the money for food or for alcohol or drugs.
Yeah.
What is the spiritually noble thing to do?
Give it.
Give them?
Just for a chance that he might be honest. Okay. Because why you suspect a man who has nothing already? He couldn't lose any more than he already does. Okay? And if he wants to lose his dignity as well, that's his problem. All right? You don't worry. You just worry about whether you have compassion or not. Okay? You give him with love. Give a man who is in need. That's it. Whatever he does. If he want to cheat you, that's his problem. Okay?
Thank you, Master.
Okay, you're welcome. I have seen a cartoon. Very cool. Maybe I told you already, but I'm not sure. Oh, it's not a cartoon, really. There was a picture on a newspaper. I forgot which one. There was two guys sit together. They lost a lot of teeth in the front already, and they still smile with the empty gum. Yeah, smile very innocently. Sit next to each other. The one on the left has a writing board in front of him. Say, why tell a lie? I need a pie. Yeah, need a drink, a pint. And make it 40 ounces. He wrote it like that in front of him. And the other one next to him, also with no teeth and grin very happily, said, me too. He wrote also a board in front of me too. Yeah. And people do give them money for drink. Yeah. Well, we do everything unconditionally, okay? Yes. Some people might cheat us, but just for a chance that they don't. Give it to them. Okay? All right. They look already so downtrodden enough, so less dignified enough already. There's no need to hurt them more by thinking that they're bad. Okay? All right. Thanks.
Dạ, kính thưa sư phụ, con có một đứa cháu đó bị accident 2 tuần rồi. Nhưng mà bây giờ đứa cháu nó đang nằm ở bệnh viện cấp cứu, sống cũng rất là khó sống mà chết cũng không có chết đó. Nhưng mà trong gia đình của anh của con á, con là cầu nguyện rất là thành tâm, cháu nó rất là tội. Vì mỗi lần mà con lên thăm á, thì con cũng rất là đau lòng. Dạ.
Tại mình đau lòng chứ nó đâu có đau gì đâu mà, cứ nói. Hả?
Thì bây giờ con cầu sư phụ.
Mình đâu biết cái gì tốt cho nó đâu. Thôi cứ tự nhiên đi hả? Cứ tới đó ngồi thiền thôi, để cho nó tự nhiên hả? Đừng có la khóc ôm sùm tội nghiệp nó.
Dạ, cảm ơn sư phụ.
Nó đang đi chơi. Ok. Mình không biết cái gì tốt cho người khác là tại tự nhiên mình thấy mình đau lòng chứ chắc gì cái người đó đau đâu. Hiểu không? Nó nằm im liệm đâu nói gì đâu mà nó âm sùng. Cái gì mình để Thượng Đế lo là xong hả? Ê, thí dụ nó đi thì trước sau thì cũng đi mà có gì đâu, phải không? Ừ, có gì. Yeah. Yeah, that's a problem. Sometimes we cannot bear. Tại mình dòm mình thấy mình đau lòng á. Chứ nhiều khi đối với người đó là tốt. Yeah, next one.
师父，我想请问一下哈，我们一般徒弟哦，都是很崇拜师父哦，就像崇拜神一样。嗯，奇怪。
干嘛？我说，不晓得这是不是跳入一种崇拜神的一个框框里面。那么我们要从怎么样从这个角度再去找到自己内心真正的秦海无上师呢？啊，多打坐就会成了，多打坐然后超过他，把他丢在了我后面。啊，那是不是崇拜师父也是第一个步骤？
是可以，从这样然后跳过去。
可以跳过去，不过我没叫你们崇拜我啊，有没有讲？啊？也许忘记讲乱七八糟哈。我想这个都要是大家内心的感受。啊，自然这样子哈，那就没办法了。如果自然就没办法控制啊，我不晓得为什么他崇拜这个人哈，觉得怪怪。我想你们为什么崇拜我，我知道了。 知道你们怎么崇拜了，啊，一种崇拜自己了，啊，喜欢了，喜欢自己会回来这个样子了，懂不懂？会找到自己的原来的那个伟大的地方，啊，我看到那个人找到了，啊，就喜欢了，喜欢他就是喜欢自己了，懂不懂？喜欢自己原来那个样子，啊，原来那个内心呢，就是这样子而已啊。 然后等一下修行对以后，就觉得没师傅没徒弟没隔开啊，没有人崇拜也没有人被崇拜，就没关系了，知道了，啊，崇拜我总比崇拜那个什么钱好啊，啊，有很多人崇拜那个什么马费啊，啊，奴隶他啊，当他的奴隶，有些人当钱的奴隶，有些人当那个名誉的奴隶，也是更糟糕啊，哈。
崇拜我没什么，我也没做什么啊，不会伤害嘛，啊，是不是？
谢谢师父。
我们可以再请问一个问题。如果我们碰到属于三界来的，他们说神明了哈，或者是阿修罗之类的灵媒，如果我们碰到这种情形的时候，我们可不可以再跟他介绍青海无上师呢？
可以啊。
难道他们不晓得您的地位吗？
知道啊。
也有你们不晓得，别人都晓得。特别在，所以在三界，他们事实上他们都知道的。特别那些无形的都知道，魔鬼什么都知道。一问这个三界的，三界以内的就有人不知道。那么是不是他们也借这个机会来毁谤您呢？
不会啊，知道人会毁谤啊。
如果是神明不会，阿修罗
也不会。
哦，只有那些比较低下层的才没有，
没有任何无形众生诽谤，只有人诽谤而已，真的。
是人的解释，人有头脑麻烦。是。哎，学
习太多不对东西，然后有什么对他的没办法分别，啊，他不了解，那因为头脑比较麻烦。
那譬如说像一贯道或天道他们。 常常有仙佛班之类的，那么仙佛班来临的时候，会交代他们很多事情，当然都教的非常好的，不管是修行啊、做人做事方面，那么他们也继续就说看低师父吗？应该是不会吧？
不会啊，
因为他们如果是神明界，是他们也应该知道，
当然
尊卑之分呐、啊。
哎。
那么就是说，我们人类宣传上而
宣传不对，哦呀，是分别性不对，名利性不对。
好，谢谢师父。
针对性不对，定真的头不对，神灵不会讲任何句。多数的神灵回去告诉他们，向清净海师傅啊，他们都不听啊。你回去问问看，你问神看看，啊，你问济公，济公啊，问他看怎么讲。我告诉你，马上去跟清净海师傅学啊。
不过他告诉几个而已啊，别人没办法跟那些神灵沟通啊，也听不到啊，而且讲他也不相信啊，他跟着他的习惯走，懂吗？
对不起，我可以再请问一个，
那
就是这个问题啊、哦，是不是我们人类啊、修行有84000个法门，是不是有些同修就需要走跟走向崇拜三界神明的这种路子修行？
嗯、哦，他像他还不了解了，才这样。
对，就是说我们像我们生生世世都有在修行、
哎，
是不是有些人必须要走那条路，而再过来生生世世，然后再终有一天会碰到师父？
任何人都有修他的方法，听懂不懂？他自己会弄一条路给他自己走的 ，OK？ 然后有时候他被影响，或是一阵子就会走到另外一条路试看看。有时候也经过我们这条路试看看，不过他们如果等级还不够标准的话，他还会再来他以前那个习惯，啊，走他自己也选择的路，嗯，直到一天他回家为止。他走慢嘛，哎，他走长的路啊，啊，有一些喜欢就要找他这啊，啊，有一些亿万富翁，他有钱啊，他有飞机啊。他有船很大，不过他还是买一部那个什么脚踏车啊，啊，踏来踏去有没有？啊，他喜欢练身体这样啊，不是说他没钱买飞机，不是买车，知道了？啊，任何众生都是佛在里面，他自己选他的路，对不对？是他自己选择 ，OK？ 哎，然后你们是选择这条路了，你们知道这条路比较快，他自己选，啊，别的他慢慢走没关系 ，OK？即使他跟我们走一阵子，然后他累了，他走太快，他不喜欢，他跑回去走路也可以。啊，有时候有人很多在外面那这样子嘛停车嘛，那我们带他一回而已啊。他不喜欢跟我们跟着一起走那么快啊，不是他回家啦，他回他自己，然后他慢慢自己骑脚踏车自己去，好了、啊。哎，有一些大便车一回这样子 ，OK， 那他回去走他的。啊，有一些自己有飞机，自己有车，自己走，嗯，你们都是有司机的，师傅开车，嗯。
那请问一下，是不是就是说，像我们，就是像我们来看待这些同修的时候，我们就是不是以平常心来看待，不用那么焦虑？
平常心，
谢谢。
谁需要你叫他？啊，他自己也是佛的，他问才讲，不问就算了，嗯。因为你讲他不一定要听啊，是吗？
呀，
公司
把师傅，我ở Việt Nam mới qua mấy tháng
này.
Dạ. Chào đồng chí. Dạ. 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 Dạ.Mỗi lần mệt con không còn nghe âm thanh nữa. Dạ, cách đây khoảng hơn 10 ngày con nằm mơ, cái con thấy con đến dự dạ tiệc với sư phụ, cái con quỳ xuống sư phụ gia trì ngay mắt cái huệ con á. Dạ, rồi gia trì trên đỉnh đầu con còn nói ủa sao sư phụ gia trì con xong rồi lâu quá vậy. Dạ, con còn nói vậy nữa. Thành ra con không biết là tại vì cái tu hành của con nó có vấn đề gì hay không.
Không có gì đâu, cái gì đâu, vấn đề đâuhả mấy người muốn cái vấn đề đó muốn mình chết không được hả?
Cảm ơn sư phụ.
Many hundreds of spiritual groups that are going to be doing what's called a 72-hour meditation over the new year.
Yes,
it's called 72 hours for peace. And I wondered if you thought it was appropriate.For us to also do that.
We do that all the time, not 72 hours, we do 70 weeks, 70 years.
I know.
Yeah. We did that all the time already since many weeks. Thank you.
Okay, it's just a.
You mean, you know, we should join them?
I wondered if you thought it would
be
a good
idea. We do that all the time. We don't have to do that just then. Okay? You don't know anything about we meditate every week here extra?No, you don't know about our group yet. You know about everybody else's group.
Of course I do.
Oh, then it's good.
Yeah, we do more extra already. We don't want to wait until the year 2000 and meditate 72 hours. Huh? It's maybe too late. If we have waited and joined them, we would have been gone long already. Maybe. But it's very good that they do that. Very good, okay? Yeah. So we do ours. We do that also, okay? Hmm?
师父,
谁? 这边, 讲。
今年生了一个宝宝，这个宝宝是胎里素，那些我要给想要给他吃素，但是我现在要给他吃荤的，那遇到这种情形怎么办？看谁比较强啊？看小孩会不会更强？找一个时候给他吃那个肉，他会吐出来。哦，对，他会不太好。那你跟先生讲，你看你要下小孩吗？他吃不下。
我是看看素食，看他会不会更健康，这样就OK了。OK，谢谢。你素温柔的说，你看，<笑>我们的小孩都不吃了，<笑>我怕他死哦。<笑>我就想尊重接待嘛，你让我试看看啊，我给他素食看看啊，会不会怎么样啊？你看佛都是素啊，但佛都80多岁啊。
跟他说，懂了？耶。跟这个师傅，刚被 tai biến mạch máu não 2 năm rồi. Hôm trước vợ con có xin sư phụ được một chùm nho. Sư phụ già sư phụ có giá trị con nhiều lắm. Hôm nay con muốn hỏi một điều là trước khi bệnh, con thiền, con được thấy ánh sáng và nghe âm thanh. Rồi từ sau khi cái ngày bị bệnh, con ngồi thiền, con không thấy gì hết và không nghe được gì hết. Mặc dù con vẫn tiếp tục ngồi thiền, không có nản chí gì hết. Vậy kính xin sư phụ giúp đỡ cho con.
Không sao đâu, cứ ngồi tiếp đi.
Không sao. Không sao sư phụ.
Không phải lúc nào cũng cần phải thấy âm thanh, mình thấy bình yên là tốt rồi đó.
Vậy hả?
Vẫn tiếp tục ngồi là tốt lắm rồi ạ. Có nhiều người thấy ánh sáng âm thanh mà cứ đâu có ngồi đâu.
Con cảm ơn sư phụ nhiều.
Bây giờ bớt ra, bớt chút ra.
Đúng 2 năm rồi, sửa hơn ngày hôm nay là đúng 2 năm 1 ngày á. Mà đỡ bớt nhiều rồi, sư phụ gia trì con bên trong và bên ngoài đỡ bớt nhiều rồi sư phụ. Cũng hy vọng là sư phụ tiếp tục gia trì cho con.
Sanh lão bệnh tử mà có gì đâu hả? Không cái này không có kia à. Cái đời này không có gì mà hoàn toàn hả? Để sung sướng hoài ha. Chỗ này là bể khổ mà, ai biết xuống đây chơi làm chi hả? Không muốn xuống mà ai bắt bác xuống đây tự bác muốn xuống, bác mới xuống đây chơi. Bác là Phật mà ai bắt được. Ok, yes.
Hi.
How
far should we take care of our physical bodies if doing so interferes with our spiritual development?
What do you think? How far would you like to go?
Well, for example, like, you know, they have herbs where you can cleanse the body, physical exercise, and I know, like, keeping the vegetarian diet, of course.
The vegetarian for compassion, for love, okay? Anyhow, herbs okay, exercise okay.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, just don't do too much, take up too much of your time.
Right. Or, I guess it could actually become you could look at it as an addiction, right? If you exercise every day or something like that.
If you are addicted to anything, that's no good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Except addicted to God is okay.
Yahoo.
Exercise you can do just enough to keep fit and enough to feel well, okay? Mm-hmm. Don't take up too much time because we will leave this body after a while.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yeah. If you are sick, yeah, if you don't feel well in some way, then you take herbs that correspond to your well-being for that purpose, yeah? If not, then there's no need to always worry about the body, whether I take this, I take that, or else I will be sick or something like that. Just keep a balanced diet, yeah? Exercise moderately, just enough. I do like six movements of exercise every day, that's all I do. If I even do it. Like I hang out myself on the tree, that's one of them. I already finished for the day. Because I forgot to do it in the morning. Yeah. Well, I do some exercise like in the morning, like three kind. Take a few seconds.
So certainly.
3 minutes. And then in the evening, 3 more minutes. Just to sleep. In the morning, 3 kind of exercise to wake me up. In the evening, 3 kinds to put me to sleep. That's it.
That's a lot.
Yeah. Take about four or five minutes per day. I've already done 1 minute. I have another 5 to go.
And so taking vitamins and minerals and those
kinds of things is
good for you and not overdoing it to be...
Yes.
If you feel you don't get it in your food.
Yes, if you want to have extra assurance of... energized, energetic body, then just do it. It won't hurt. And if you take too much, the body will eliminate. Yeah? I think it's good to take vitamins or herbs because the companies will be happy. They sell in their products.
That's right.
No harm? Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Super. Thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah?
I have a question about how to change limiting thought patterns. I feel as though I am my biggest limiting factor in my life and my limiting beliefs about my self-worth. I feel as though the way I talk to myself inside my head limits the way I am able to enjoy my life.
Oh,
and
like what? You want to enjoy what in life?
Well, I have very negative thought patterns and I... like I go for a job interview and
you tell yourself that you're going to fail.
No, I start telling myself why the job's not the right one for me, or I'll go out date a guy and start. It's like I don't believe that I'm worthy of
that guy.
That guy, the job, money.
I thought you say the good is not good for you. You think the job is not good, or you think yourself is not good?
Well, it's like I judge myself inside, and so I judge everything else outside.
Maybe the job is no good. But you do that all the time?
All the time.
24 hours? Wow, that's very tiring. I don't know how you sit there and breathe, huh? Why couldn't you just let it go, huh? Are you dating somebody now?
No.
Are you dating any job now?
No, I'm looking for a job.
Looking for one. So what is the reason that it makes you think that any job is no good?
Well, I start worrying about whether or not I'll have enough time to meditate, whether I'll be able to find
that. No.
Whether or not they'll be able to pay me enough money, whether I'll be able to find a decent place to live near there, just anything.
Blah, blah, blah.
I mean, and it's not just with the job, it's the way I approach everything in my life. It's like I'm so...
Okay.
Negative in my viewpoint that I can't let in the good stuff right in front of me.
Wow.
That I mean, I feel as
that's
though...
That's very positive that you recognize your own weakness.
Well, that's it. It's like I feel like everything I need is right here. If only I could, like, unlock something in my brain and let myself accept it.
Okay. How do you unlock it? Do you have any idea?
Meditate more?
No. You meditate enough already, right? I don't think you are neglecting your meditation. You just make use of your wisdom now. You store too much in there and you don't use it. Okay? Every time you go to the job now, when you start to think negative, push it aside, think negative, positive to replace it, okay? For example, you come in, okay, here goes again. This job may be not good enough for me. You have to think right away. Who knows? Maybe it's a good company here. Maybe get promotion. Maybe I have a better payment here, maybe a better environment here, maybe a better good job, maybe a better working atmosphere here. Maybe I met a boyfriend here, maybe I get married to the boss next year. Yeah. Maybe he loves me so much, I inherit the whole company. Hey, why not? Who knows? Who guarantee that you won't have that? Yeah. And if you say, okay, this will never happen, this is impossible, then how do you know that all the negative things you think is will be possible? Anyhow, who guarantees both sides, okay? So just think that positive, even if it won't come true, it won't cost you anything. At least you try some new job, have fun, you know, knowing the new people, okay? That's exciting. And if you don't like it, there's still a lot of chance that you can get out. To get in is difficult, get out is easy, right? You know that. And you have a choice all the time. If you don't like it, you find another job until you like it. So just have fun, okay? But be patient, give yourself time to get used to it, environment with, and colleagues, have fun with them. Know new people, knowing new stuff from them. They might teach you something new, they might acquaint you with new people. They might teach you something that you did not know, they might take you some new restaurant that you like. And you might be able to find an apartment that you never thought is as good as that. See what I mean? So just try it. The worst thing is that you will lose that job, yeah? Because you don't find an apartment, you cannot have enough money, whatever. Then you know. Okay? Until then, you don't give any answer yet, okay? Do it first. Then you think in yourself, what would the master do in my position? Just think like that and try to think, okay, what would she do then? Would she run away? Would she think like I do now? Or would she just try? Yeah, or would she just think of all the positive things? Or hope for the best? Yeah, okay? Or think, if you don't believe me, think what Jesus would think right now. Okay, what Buddha would think right now. Right? What the God inside you would like to do right now in your situation. Okay, use him, use your God. Use your guide inside. Have fun. Job can be fun. New colleagues can be fun. New company be fun. Yeah? Just make it a fun. An adventure. Yeah. An adventure is full of risk, okay?
Assalamu alaikum, Master.
Assalamu alaikum,
sister. I do have lots of thoughts and I do have questions.
Yes.
Actually, I do know how to ask him, because you mentioned addiction to God. And I think that's where I start. And you said, like, addiction to God is okay.
It's not really an addiction, I'm just making fun of it, okay?
But that's how I feel, exactly.
You're addicted?
Yes, actually, I'm addicted.
That's good. You make your life better, no?
Yes, it is, but it's very painful when I have to come back to this dimension and I have to take care of the worldly things, you know, like taking care of the kids. It's very painful. And it's like I have to kind of drag myself into it.
Oh, no.
And I just feel like I have to get back. So that's when I feel, okay, that's when I feel that I really am getting addicted. And I wanted to ask you, is this normal?
You're just going through that stage, you know, like when you first love somebody, you want to be with him all the time. But after a while, it will be more normalized.
I hope so.
Yeah, try to think of what God would like you to do. Okay? He entrusted these children into your hands.
Yes.
If you were God, what would you do? Right? Do your best. Make them comfortable. Because they are God too. So if you are addicted to God, then take care of the God within you. You know, within your hands, within your responsibility. He's a little God.
Exactly. That's what I've been trying to do, like, for the past 4 months.
But God month?
No. 1 month. 1 month.
Yes.
I've kind of kind of brought myself back in this world.
Yeah.
But it's very painful, and whenever I get time, and then I cry.
Oh my God. Oh my God. What do you do? Tell you how to meditate again?
No.
Oh, give the kids to me and you meditate.
I still meditate, but it's just that I want to go back. I don't like
it. Yeah, you will go back. It's just a few more years. Huh? Well, it's too late now to complain. You have enjoyed your fun and making the kids and complain. Okay, give them to me. I take care while you meditate. Yeah, I don't know.
Okay, so
I take care of them while you meditate. Wow, it's fun to have kids running around all your place, you know that? A lot of people pay millions of dollars for their kids to have it. Your kids are your treasure. They love give you company.
Yes, that is true.
Yes. You have to remember.
Yes.
Remember, they are your treasure. You know, God gives you company. And they even are initiated, and that's so good. Yeah? They are your friends. They are there to accompany you, make you happy, but you're too busy thinking of yourself. And forget to look for happiness that they come to bring you. Enjoy them, okay? Meditate as much as you can. God is always within you. There's no need to run around anywhere or panic about Him. Yeah?
I just want to be with Him all the time.
No, you are with Him all the time. It's you who have problem. You separate yourself from Him and from your kids. Okay? He's running all over your house. Every day. And you say, I want to be with Him all the time. Isn't that funny? Huh?
Mm-hmm.
You don't see God in their sparkling eyes?
I do.
All right? Mm-hmm. Hug them. Kiss the God. Hug that God all the time, then you never lose Him. Okay? Don't be silly. You are so perfect. You have just a perfect life. Even if you want to go back to the kingdom of God, we have a lot of time. Okay? We have time. Yes, and even if you die tomorrow, you go straight to heaven. So don't worry about it. Okay?
Thank you.
Yeah, we all like to sit and enjoy the bliss of samadhi, I know that. But you are even tougher. You enjoy both and you can take care of your family at the same time. It's too late now to talk about running away from them. Yes. So you have both. You're even lucky. You see? Some people just have children and don't have samadhi. Okay? Some people just have samadhi and don't have the living gods running around them. You have both. You don't have anybody running around. Oh, little gods. They are there to protect you, yeah? To teach you love and to bring you happiness. So be grateful. Be grateful that you will see all that you will have to look to find the gifts that they bring you. Don't be so blind and oblivious to the gift that God wants to present to you, okay? Don't be attached to one thing and forget the other, because they're both just nice, yeah? Look carefully and you will find what they are there for. Okay? Have fun. Welcome. But I'm also very glad to hear a woman who was so in love with God like that. And she has everything, you know? She has positions, she has two husbands, she has three beautiful children, she has house, everything, but she's still in love with God. Isn't that great? Yeah. Yeah. Yes, at least that's the lesson they teach you about yourself, okay? So you realize how great you are, okay? They sacrifice to be a little one, being dictated to, and being even looked down upon, so that you can know how great you are. That's the gift they want to give you, okay? Otherwise, how would you realize it? Huh?
Oh, you're so blind, all of you. All of these blind saints. Blind and deaf saints. Don't even know how good you are and how blessed you are. Okay, and this gentleman over here, give him a mic. You finished, love? You finished? Okay. I hope you're happy from today with your kid. Yeah. Okay.
I was just going to say regarding the herbs,
that
mentioned before, that I used to take like 5-6 different kinds of herbs.
Every day?
And yes, and I found that some of them are very strong, and mostly they have a stimulating effect that is very bad for meditation.
Oh, really? Yeah. You take it only when you need for certain things. You don't just take at random, you know?
Yeah.
It's not also medicine.
Yeah. But most of it, they say you should take it every day.
Well, no, it depends on what time of the day. If you take it in the morning or at night.
Yeah.
If you want to sleep, then take sleepy herbs. You want to wake, then take active herbs. See?
Yeah, so anyway, I find that the best is to not to take any of them.
Also fine, just
even coffee or anything that's stimulating.
Really,
meditation will take care of the heart problems anyway, so.
Yeah, when they don't meditate strong enough, it protects them. It's all right. Sometimes you don't meditate enough, you know that? Or people, I mean other people, they work too hard, or they are too tired, you know, or their body has already been weakened before I came to meditation, yeah? So it takes some time to recover, so they're okay to take some herbs. It is suitable for them. Some people take some suitable herbs and they feel better. See, not everybody like you, huh?
Well, I understand that. I'm just talking from my experience.
Yes, yes.
And when I was taking them, I thought they did help. But then I tried the not to take any and it works out best that way.
Good! We have to find out, they say. Yeah, okay. Right. You have to find out what's good for you. Yeah? You don't eat, you don't take. We need to
take. Thank you, Sư Phụ. Ở 7 năm qua, tôi biết tôi vô cho nên những giọt thức vô đến nhất, Sư Phụ vẫn không bỏ tôi. Trong ngày 25 tháng 10 vừa qua,
bỏ đâu có được, còn như kéo réo không sao mà bỏ được.
Thưa sư phụ, con đến nhà bác sĩ Đặng Trần Hào để xin cứu, thì được biết ngày 25 tháng 10 vừa qua, ngày 12 kỷ niệm ông thị trưởng Hawaii đặt bức tượng tri ân sư phụ. Con là một nhân chứng sống thực được vì nhìn thấy những việc làm đầy tình thương, ưu ái của sư phụ đối với nghệ sĩ chúng con đã một thời hoang vắng tại quê nhà. Điển hình là con, những giờ phút đau thương nhất, gần một cách chết nhất, sư phụ đến trong giấc mơ, an ủi, chăm sóc, tạo giải phẫu của con vượt qua. Và con nghĩ rằng, con phải đến đây để xin gặp sư phụ. Con sẽ trở thành một đệ tử của sư phụ. Trong 7 năm qua, sư phụ đã đặt kỳ vọng nuôi con và con đã làm sư phụ thất vọng. Nhưng mà con nghĩ rằng con đã làm được cái việc mà sư phụ đã làm bấy lâu nay trong môn mặt mà sư phụ không cần phổ biến. Mà con là một người trong tay con có cả thức thanh, tại sao con không phổ biến những việc làm có ích đó cho sư phụ? Và con đã là một bức thơ để kính cẩn sư phụ và quý đồng tu lên. Lòng con nao nao sắp diện kính sư phụ. Đêm qua con hồi hộp bồi hồi, thiền sư ơi, ngài có hiểu lòng con. 7 năm chẳng ngày xa con vạn dặm, tâm tưởng con luôn luôn nhớ đến ngài. Con vẫn biết ngài như hình với bóng, lẻo đẻo theo nâng đỡ đứa con thờ.
và đòi qua công đức ôi vô lượng giúp đỡ người võ tác thiên tai. Lòng ưu ái bao dung như hiền mẫu, trí dũng đô như hoàng hải đăng. Nơi quê nhà, văn nghệ sĩ thời vang bóng, sư phụ chạy lòng xót xa tuôn.
Study with other teachers, and we've pretty much been on a quest for a long while, and we really appreciate your warmth, closeness, and your approachability, which so you're so real. It's quite distinct from what we found in other travel.
I guess they all have.
Know that you speak on it too, but from my interpretation, each teacher has a different job, and they're working with people at different levels, accomplishing different things.
Right.
And we've had so many of the things that you answered tonight at the initiation, or your monk did, are things that other teachers couldn't even begin to respond to us about. So we really appreciate it.
You're welcome. Well, I don't know what to teach, but this is the basic thing that you know. We are just basic yet. Not today, the initiation is basic thing. If they couldn't answer you that, I don't know what they're teaching. Right?
Then they're teaching remedial, I guess, just to start. I think they're doing good work too.
Oh, they do what they
do. So many Westerners are just. You know, 10, 20 years of TM started it all. Yeah. Things like that. That's been great also. Service. Great service.
It's good also because they begin them to understand about spiritual life more, have more tendency for vegetarian and all that. Very good.
It's nice here.
It's nice here, huh? I'll be welcome. Come back anytime. It's your home.
I haven't done a retreat with you yet. Since initiation.
You don't have to do a retreat.
But it's so amazing to meditate with you. It's like unbelievable.
You know that.
Today.
Today was good.
Just for that 15 minutes.
Uh-huh.
When you were in the room was like 1,000 times more powerful than other times.
You must be very sensitive.
Yeah, okay. I felt like my head was being operated on.
Wow. And you want to sit for 7 days with me? You think your head can hold it together? Just 15 minutes and your head is exploding.
No, it was good.
What a wonderful surprise.
What?
It was to hear that you were coming here. Because I wasn't able to accommodate going to South Africa. And I just feel so blessed to be able to see you and meet you.
Well, since I'm here, I've come to visit you.
Well, I thank you.
I didn't want to stay, I must tell you honestly. I'm also having my mood and my laziness and my mind. You know, I don't know, I'm not going. Yeah, I want to leave already yesterday. But I hang on for you guys. Yeah, I really did.
Thank you.
I really did. I tell you, it's hard. It's not all that easy for me sometimes just to hang on in there to see you, for your sake. I don't know. Sometimes the pressure is so great, I just want to leave. Yeah. But I just stay and then it's got better, and I'm glad I did. And I think you're glad too. So that makes two of us. Yeah? Good.
I want to give a testimony to what I've experienced from meditation. One of the things is just a reduction in fear.
Yeah?
Yes.
It will disappear altogether. You will disappear.
It's just incredible.
Yeah?
Yes, I work with, I'm a singer, I work with audiences. Mm. And I used to go out there and I was kind of afraid.
Yeah?
Yeah. I try not to show it, but now I really don't feel it that much.
Oh, that's good.
So that's been a great benefit. I thank you.
Oh, you meditate more and then you just fly over the audience.
Thank you.
They will fear you. My God, what's that guy? He's so tough. Oh, we better listen or else. Yeah. I'm glad for you. I have experienced the same thing that you are experiencing now, and even more so. Yeah. And I know it works. Yeah. So you just continue your chosen path, and whatever you want in your life, you will have it. Okay? Now you're welcome. Thank yourself. You're working for yourself. Yeah. Whatever you have is your own work. Yeah, be proud of yourself. It's not an easy path, but it's not difficult either. Yeah, it depends on what you want to do with your life. Yeah, it depends on how you want to spend your time. What is the most beneficial? There are three ways to spend your time. One beneficial, the other one is detrimental, and the other one is neutral. You see? So you spend time which is beneficial to you spiritually, and that in turn will benefit any other things in your life. Yeah. So the wisest choice is practice spiritual, and everything else will come your way. If you just take care one by one in your different departments of your life, you'll be successful too, but one and then one, or maybe not even successful. But if you take care of your spiritual need, and everything else will come into place. Yeah? So that's the wisest choice. And you made that choice, so you have only yourself to thank. Yeah, I'm only sitting here handing candies. Yeah, and be an example of success, you know, in spiritual practice. That's all. And then if you want to do the same thing, then you're welcome. But you are doing it, okay? I don't take credit for anything. Just sit in here.
I'm going to give you
some
credit.
Oh, yeah.
Really, I sense your presence with me. Because I'm going to
feel it.
Yes. When I look for things, it's just like that one. I'm just led to go look for a particular place, and there it is.
Yes.
And then I feel I'm more intelligent.
Sure.
And powerful.
Oh, yes. Yes, you are. You'll be more and more intelligent and more powerful. Yes, because it's you, it's God. You are God inside. As long as you forget the mind for a while and use your own power, your real self, which is God, a part of God, as powerful as you can be.
That is a big change.
Yeah. Yes, of course. Yeah. Whatever I tell you is true. Yeah. Yes. Just practice and you get everything you have, everything you ever want, you will have. Yeah? You will have a better life than I do. Yes, because you don't have responsibility. So if sometimes if you see me suffer or something, don't look at that. I'm the teacher. I take on some of the burden of the people. But you have to just enjoy. Yeah. It cannot be otherwise, you know, because the God in you is awakening. And you cannot escape from enjoyment, happiness, intelligence, wisdom, strength, power, whatever. You cannot escape from that. Yeah.
This is a very quick, practical question. I have a chemical deficiency, and a medical doctor prescribed salmon oil,
yes,
and whitefish oil. So I'm going to ask him if there are alternatives. But if there are no alternatives to that medication, what should I do?
What is the white fish oil for?
What's it for?
Yeah. What does it help you?
I have a mental situation.
I don't see any problem with you.
I have a bipolar condition, and we just went through a bunch of medical tests where I'm low in tryptophan, other things.
Are you sure that you have problems?
Yeah, I've had it for years. I inherited it from sometimes I'm not able to function for 2-3 weeks, and I hope this meditation will help as well.
It will, definitely.
But
everybody can tell you that. Yes, right, guys?
Salmon, S-A-L-M-O-N, don't take it. And don't take the white fish oil, take sesame oil. Right?
Sesame oil, vitamin D, a lot of other vitamins.
Oh yeah, I have a lot of other things. They've actually done all the chemical tests and analyzed my foot.
You'll be fine in no time.
Okay. Thank you.
Just meditate a little bit more every day. Okay. Enjoy. You know, your sickness has to do with your profession before.
Well, if you say so, then it must be true. I have faith. Yeah, so it's a chemical imbalance, what the psychiatrist and so forth say.
You don't have any problem, all right?
Okay. From now on?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mary, talk to you? Yes, possible. It's possible.
Okay. So it took me a while to realize it was real.
Yes.
But it's something about frightened, because I just like, you know, if people know about that, you know, I have these.
Don't tell people.
Yeah.
Okay? You can tell him or tell me maybe that. The less you tell, the better.
Right.
And not too many people have this kind of experience. And least understand it. If you tell them, they might think you're crazy, or they make trouble for you more. They make you confused. Yes. Okay. Keep zip, zip. Yeah, your experience is a blessing to you. It should be for you alone. Okay? If you need any answer, you can write to me about it. But actually, if you have good experience, you feel elated, you feel happy, that is the answer already. That means it's a blessing for you. And if you see a lot of things in your vision, keep going, okay? Because you know what it's like when people know too much about your inside. They don't believe it. They don't know what you know, okay? So just be quiet and enjoy, all right? Relax. When Mary comes, you talk to her. Ask her questions. And now you have the weapon to even, you have the means to discern whether she's real or not. Okay? You repeat the holy name and ask her if she's real. And even if it's a negative power, they have to be honest to you inside. So if you ask them, are you the truth? Are you real? They will disappear. Okay? But if they stay there and converse with you and teach you some wisdom, make you happy, that's okay. That's how we learn, see, in a higher dimension. You see, Jesus and Buddha, and talk to them, that's normal. Yeah, just other people, they don't have it, they will feel very puzzled. So you better don't ask them, because they don't know. Just because they are teachers of some kind doesn't mean they have experience you have. Doesn't mean they know what you know, okay? Right? Because you're blessed. Maybe they're not. All right?
See, now she feels less lonely.
How?
Her scary things.
Oh no, there's no scary things. You're okay, you're right, you're fine. You're blessed, yes. A lot of us have this similar experience. Yeah, like the Catholic would see Buddha and the Buddhist would see Jesus and all confusing. And we just welcome them all. Yes. And do they look crazy to you? No, they don't. Okay, then you know they're fine. And if they're fine, you're fine, because you have same experience, yeah? You're blessed, you're pure, and you're blessed with vision of the higher being, you know? Higher dimensional being, yeah. So just be happy, yeah? All right?
Relax.
See, yeah, of course, can do anything. That's definitely happen. No problem.
She doesn't want to come back like
me. Yeah, nobody wants to come back here, of course. Not when we saw the celestial world. Not after that. We sometimes don't want to come back here. I know that. But it's fast. This world, just a few more years and we're gone. It's already year 2000, you see. I don't remember when I was born, and now I'm already 40-something. Oh my God. Yeah, so don't worry. Time goes fast now, okay? Just take care of whatever you have to do and make it as hobby. Make fun, okay? Enjoy what you're doing, yeah? Enjoy it. First, maybe if you like it, then enjoy it as a blessing from God. If you don't enjoy it, then try to think that it's something you have to take care of. You have to pay off before you go. Either way, just do it. Zip, do it, and go later, okay? Don't worry, don't complain about the time here, don't complain about that you should stay in heaven and not stay on earth. Why not? Actually, everywhere is heaven, you know? If you have heaven in here, everywhere is heaven. Where else should heaven be? Huh? Except in you. Don't complain. Stay home, stay here, enjoy. Enjoy your husband, enjoy your children, enjoy your work, enjoy the money, enjoy whatever. Meditate, yeah? And when time comes, it's quick. It's quicker than you think. Yeah, quicker than you think. Maybe tomorrow even. Take care of whatever you have to do here, okay? Because you don't have so much time. All right? You don't have next life to do it. So just do it. Do anything. Anything you have to do, do it. Unless you want to come back. No, huh? Okay. Any other question? More question? Where will I be?
On the new millennium.
Oh, I'll be where I am. What the millennium? What have
what
to do with it?
Either January 1st, where all the Y2K thing. No. Do you have any opinion, or you don't talk about it?
No, Y2K, they took care already.
Took care already?
They took care already. Yeah. They can check, yeah, but it's some poor country, maybe they have a little problem, but they already have a solution. No? They don't. Then we don't need computer. Then we don't need whatever, okay? Before computer, we survive. After computer, we survive. I don't know what's big deal about millennium. Huh? Just another 1,000 years, the next is another 1,000, next another 1,000. It's continuing forever. I should worry about every day. That's it. Okay, millennium or not, we just have one day to live at the time, right? Suppose it's 3,000 years now, what would we do? What does it do to you? Nothing. You are initiated, you are elevated, you are enlightened, you are a saint, continue your life. Okay? Don't go with the trend of the world and worry too much about millennium or not, or whatever, huh? No problem, you're cool. Next one? I congratulate you. Congratulate you. Making a wise choice, a very noble choice. And you will feel different every day if you're really sincere, you know, okay? You're free, free. You're a free man from today. No Maya can bind you. No angel of death can call you. You're free, complete from the cycle of transmigration, from the karmic law of this physical world. You're free. You are a free man from today, from initiation. Free, absolutely. If you know how free you are, you'll probably die. Too happy. Too happy. Don't want anything anymore. Just go. Yes, it's true. Just we have a little give and take still here, yeah? A few more days, a few more months, a few more weeks, a few more years, no matter. We take care and then we go. Just like your ticket already booked, yeah? Now you pack your luggage slowly. Take care of whatever bills, and then you go. Very simple. I wouldn't worry about anything anymore after initiation. I think after initiation, we could just go die. Actually, no problem. Yeah? Thank you. Okay? Yeah? Question? All right.
I want to know the difference between the wisdom and the wisdom eye and the wisdom in one's heart, hearing the voices in the mind that go, I can't do this, or
no, I understand. Okay. Mind has no wisdom. Okay? It's just recorded what you... It's just recorded what you encounter every day or what's been put into it, okay? So for example, your mother keeps telling you don't eat ice cream because. So whenever you see an ice cream, your mind starts screaming at you, don't because. Okay? Just like a record player, all right? And the heart, it's not a wisdom center, okay? It's a center for feeling, okay? And that's why when you love somebody, you say, oh, you know, it's the affair of the heart, see? All right? The wisdom center is here. I mean, because we're in a physical body, I have to say somewhere, right? But the wisdom center is not in here, of course. But it's in, if you are in a physical body, you have to find it in here. Okay? Inside your brain, in the middle, there's a spot, all right? To start with, yeah? Later you find out that you are everywhere. And you are the wisdom. You don't need to find the wisdom, but you have to start it from somewhere, okay? The heart chakra is functioning for some other reason, not to find wisdom, all right? And besides, the real heart is not the physical one that's pounding in your chest. Understand?
All right.
Any other question?
I seem to, when I base my decisions, I base them from what I feel.
Mm-hmm.
Is that okay to do that instead of if I don't know how developed my wisdom center is here? Mm-hmm. Is that okay? Or should I try to do
it? If it makes you feel good and successful, it's okay. Actually, there's no much. Okay. It depends on what. For example, if you love a man, yeah? Most of your feeling come from the heart, and that's not always a wise decision, okay? Maybe your heart overrule your wisdom, but that's okay too. Who tell you whom to love anyhow, right? But if it's a business matter, then you have to base things in two things, yeah, in order to be successful. Number one is your intuition, yeah? You feel this thing is right. Number two are the facts that you have gathered, the data, so that you know that, okay, I'm doing this is right according to physical knowledge, yeah? And intuition, okay? Feeling maybe you misinterpret, like feeling sometimes it could be intuitive, you see what I mean? Yeah, so you have to be careful, see whether it's intuition.
So through the meditation then, we can develop this wisdom eye so we have our faith and confidence to make decisions from the business center.
Yes. Almost, the more you meditate, the more you feel right about things you do. You almost have it. I say, oh, I know. That's that. You know the answer.
When I meditate, I find myself in a lot of times, like, willing things to happen, you know, instead of really giving over to the faith of letting go, you know, because I feel like, oh, I'm so grateful, like, if I don't keep just postulating, you know, this has to happen, this has to happen, this has to happen.
Oh, that's the mind.
And I, maybe I'm afraid to just let go and let God let things happen, because I feel like, oh, maybe they won't if I don't just keep
going.
And I don't know how to
go with
that.
Well, you have to also do your job, yes? You have to keep track of your job and do what is right for your business, yeah? And you meditate, it's just to clarify more of which decision to take. So that's also all right. But you don't keep pushing things much in meditation for that direction, okay? You ask for wisdom, for guidance, okay? And if you have some intuition comes along during meditation, you just have a little pad, notebook with you all the time. And if there are any idea, you write it down, and later you check it in. Okay?
so I don't have to keep going. And he just has this, 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 I can just let go and ask for the wisdom.
Yes. Yes. When you meditate, you should relax only. Forget all the things that you should do and not do. But if you should come across any idea, that means maybe Master give you some guidance, and you write it down on a piece of note of paper, write short, only for you to understand. Yeah, and so that you don't forget it later. That's it. But don't try to sit there and say, Master, I meditate 2.5 hours. Now this 2 million business has to go through, okay? You just do your best. And whatever happens, will happen. All right? Don't try to think too much. You're so scary. You think too much, you disappear. You have to analyze too much, huh? Relax. Yeah, most of the time we just let go and meditate and things just happen. Really. Or we just know what to do.
So why do we not continue?
You don't want to meditate? Tired, right? Yes, then just do that. You know already the answer. No need asking, huh? You see, when you meditate, all the good things happen. That's right. Instead of spending your energy in thinking what you're pushing things, just meditate. Right? Okay, if you cannot help it and you're still pushing the meditation, then just let it be. Try your best, recite the holy name, just meditate. All right? Oh, we don't live that long, okay? Just don't disappear too fast.
I always got a lot of relaxation from breathing. And then I'm told I can't really do it now. I mean, I guess I can't do it during the
What kind of breathing you do?
How
long? How long breathing?
Minutes. No.
No. Just breathe and feel, it's okay.
Deep breathe, it really relaxes me.
That's fine. What that means is
can
the...
I do it during the meditation and...
The, you do that? No need to do that. Just normal breathing. Take a deep breath for fresh air,
I'm
you know?
I can do it, just not during the Kuan Yin.
You're going to have some confusion if you mix it too many
times. Okay. But just other times.
All right, do it until you're fed up with it. And you know it's no good for you and then you'll leave. Okay? I don't want to forbid you. I just tell you what is better for you. Okay? If you want to hang on to it for a while, it's all right. Yeah. But knowing that it doesn't help you very much with your spiritual progress, that's all. Okay? Because it's too physical, alright? Concentrate, because there's a different type of thinking, you understand? Like, that's just to keep your body in shape and all that. And that, we do it also. Little exercise, little breathe for fresh air, you know, but just by the way, it doesn't become a method like in that type.
Well, I feel I get a lot of health benefits from it, and I feel I need that, because for a long time I've been struggling with and I'm wondering, does that meditation help as much without the health aspect as well?
Health?
Yeah. Your meditation.
Oh. Have you not yet tried?
I mean, I've been doing the convenient.
Oh, that's a different thing.
Yeah.
Okay. Later, do the whole thing. And then you know it yourself. Okay. Is that beneficial to your health also, guys?
Yes.
Yes.
You know, there's some people who are really attracted to certain causes. You know?
Certain what?
causes,
yeah.
And like, for example, people who have this need to protect animals.
Yes.
And I was wondering, is it because in some past life they were a suffering animal, or is that? I'm just wondering.
Why you wonder so much about that?
People, I've been wondering a long time.
Yeah. Yes.
I don't have to know, but
of course, they have had affinity with them, or they have been with them as one of them. Don't you ever wonder why the owner and the dog look so much the same? For example, you wander and wander along in that direction. Some people look even like the bird that they kept. Some people look even like the turtle. Tortoise, yes, I've seen one. She rides tortoise, you know, she has turtle, as pets. And she looked exactly like them. My God. I saw people look like dog, cat, but I have never believed that people could look like a tortoise. But it happened in Germany, yes. So that is something more for you to wonder, hey? Yeah. You see, people, before they are born into this world, they have chosen a mission to do, to progress in their own spiritual quest. Yeah? Okay, we left God, all right? Begin like this. We left God, say goodbye to Him. From today, I don't recognize you anymore. I'm done with you, I'm finished, I will be the opposite of you. And then, from then on, from the opposite, you start to climb back again to the same with God. You understand? And that's what you're doing right now. You are at the end of your journey now. That's why you came to Guanyin Method. Everything else people do outside Guanyin Method is also a kind of practice. You understand? Be it taking care of animal, be a doctor, be a nurse, be a lawyer, whatever. That's their own practice. That's why the Buddhists say you have 84,000 methods of practice. It's just a way of speaking. We have more than that. You see, everyone chooses a way to go back to where they belong. But first they have to separate from God in order to recognize God. This is a paradox, but it's like that. If you are God already, you can't recognize God. This is a problem. So you have to be different from God in order to go back to recognize God. Or else what you do? Be God forever and just sit there, do nothing? That's how we do this. We have fun. See? The cycle. All right? So maybe these people have chosen that kind of work, yeah, to further their career, further their spiritual career. Yeah? Okay? But when you end, at the end of it, then you come to Guanyin Method. All right? Yes. Just like college, university. Yes. Okay. Everything else is slowly going up to that. Okay, what else? I hope I make myself clear. Yeah? Okay. It's a long story. Yes. It's funny how we have to be separated from God in order to be one with God, huh? Can you understand that or not?
Yeah.
Just maybe the absence makes the heart go fonder or something like that. Huh? Because if you're God, you don't know you're God. Nothing to compare. If we all have woman in this world, we will not know what man is. We will not know that we are woman. Because we know we are woman when we face a man. You understand what I mean? When we know what man is, then we know, yes, I'm woman. In the contrary to men, like that. So in order to know God, to know that you are God, you have to be different from God first, see? And then work your way back. Yeah. Well, that's that. Nothing big deal. Yeah? So eventually everybody will go back to God. Yeah? Whatever way they choose. So it doesn't matter if they choose TM, they choose rice animal, they protect rare species, whatever. You know, that's their practicing method. It doesn't look spiritual to you, but it is. Everything is spiritual. It's just the degree, yeah, the nearness to Godhood. The Guanyin method is the nearest. See, the last step you have to climb of the ladder of evolution in order to go back to where we came from. All right? Everything else is same, spiritual. Everything else. Yeah, to cultivate, vegetable, to be a farmer, to be a driver, to be a post office work, anything is spiritual work. Yeah? But now, see, you came back you came to the Guanyin method already. Everything else, because you're already doing it along and you haven't finished, so you just tied it up, you know, like finalize it and then go. Right? So you don't have to leave your home, you don't have to leave your work, you don't have to go crazy, go to Himalaya, things like that, you know. I went there so that you don't have to go. Okay? All right.
What attracted me to you, I was watching some of your videos and I was seriously looking for a guru and our sage in India. I was wanting to go there and I didn't know how I was going to go about doing that. And then in one of your lectures, I heard you talk about that. I said, hallelujah, here I come.
It's easy, convenient. Yes, yes. I wouldn't like you to go to Himalaya, it's so dangerous. You might not come back alive in one piece. It's very dangerous. Yes. Oh, yeah. Snowstorm. Landslide.
I heard it was, you know,
avalanche. Everything could happen to you, anything.
I had heard that it was very easy. I had heard totally the opposite.
Easy?
Yes. You know, just show up there and someone would take
show
you
up
in.
Yeah. Yeah, someone might take you in after you walk 40 miles to somewhere. If you find anybody to take you in at all, in that region. Yeah, wow. All this fairy tale you read about Himalayas, forget it. It's not as it is, okay? Sometimes people make more fairy tale out of it, but their reality is not like that, okay? You walk in snow that deep, as high as a mountain, and you get buried any time, or you slip, and then you fall in a ravine or whatever, pit, huh? Yeah, edge, and then you become one piece of snow here and there.
I had heard of the city called Kula, and when I tried to find it on the world map, there was no such city. Mm. And to go back and contact the person that had told me all this wonderful news, I did not know how to do that.
Yeah. You didn't know how to find him?
No, I had visited Mexico and had met him there, and he gave me some insight about India. So when I came back, I was all enthused to go to India.
Yeah. Well.
And so thank you for doing that for us.
Yeah. Nothing there.
I'm not going.
Nothing there that you don't have here. Okay? It's just danger. Very difficult time. You can't carry too much luggage because you always have to climb uphill.
That's the problem.
The path is about that big sometimes, and you slip your foot, you're finished. When I was there, I took only two pair of clothes, you know, like pajama style. Thinner than that, this Indian cotton, just put there, one pullover like this, and one sleeping bag, and one, aluminium plate so you can, a little bit deeper plate so you can cook chapatis, cook water, cook tea on it, too, just one. First of all, I brought a lot, I brought books, guide map for Himalaya, guide map for spiritual master, where is the ashram, which gurus live the longest, everything, umbrella and spoon, stainless steel spoons, stainless steel cups, all kind of things, but as I go up, I throw them all down. And last, I have just one that aluminium, because stainless steel is too heavy still. Aluminium is lighter. So I exchange that, and then one spoon, and one dish like that, yeah. And one staff to walk when it's too stiff, you rely on that. when you walk downhill, you rely on that to stop you from falling down. And you carry the sleeping bag, which is become heavier and heavier every day because the rain will soak in, the snow will make it cold and stiff. And you, my feet walk like, you know, sports shoes like this. And the snow was so deep and the rain was continuous sometimes. And my feet continuously, you know, like ice. It doesn't move, the feet. And it was swollen and all that. And I didn't have enough fire to warm it up at the end of the day. And my clothes, I have to wear it wet all the time, even though I have two pairs. But I wash one and wear one. But sometimes I wash, but it don't dry. Because it rains and the Himalaya is damp, you know, and I don't have time and the fire to dry it all the time. So I sleep on the ground like this, don't even have this. It's a mud ground and it's very wet and it's muddy and you just put a plastic sheet on it. You know those very thin, the army use, one side gold, one side silver, very thin like plastic, very thin like paper. Put it on the ground and I put my sleeping bag, and sometimes my sleeping bag is so cold. I couldn't get warm. I'm small, you know, and no fat. But sometimes if you're lucky, you find some other pilgrim, and they have fire, so you just sit, you know, behind them. A little bit far, but it's okay, and I put my sock in front like that. And it get a little dry, but not complete. And if I want to be more comfortable, I have to carry more clothes, but how do I do that? Huh? And you could have people carry you, or you have horse carry you sometimes, in some strength or not all, because most of the place you have to walk alone. And because I walk very slow, sometimes I'm left behind all the time, and I have to walk alone a long time and catch up with other people. You know, I don't walk in group, but some people who walk there in summer, different places of Himalaya. And you have to encounter sometimes snakes and, you know, bugs and dangerous animals. And you don't have toilet facility, you don't have hot water to take shower. You have to jump in the river with 0 degrees because the water just melted from the mountain. Just like zero, yeah? It melted because it's summer, there's some sun, so the snow begin to melt. And the ice begin to melt, then that's where your water is. And if you want to cook some hot water, you have to buy wood. And wood there is very expensive, like gold. Because people have to carry it up there. Or they carry gas to cook, you know, because wood doesn't seem to burn very much there because the air is so thin. And the water don't boil. I boil only little water like that, it don't boil.
A long time. Why? Because of the altitude again.
It takes a long time, it doesn't even boil. Yeah, it just stay like that forever. So I got fed up, I eat raw. Yeah, I just eat whatever vegetable I found. Because sometimes you don't find houses or even shop anywhere. And even if you find a shop, they don't always have enough things to make chapatis for you. Because the shop, they're also poor, very small. They have only one bucket of flour, for example, like that. And if they encounter like 50 pilgrims, then you can share only half of the chapatis. They don't have any more. It's a high altitude. It's very difficult to cook, difficult to bring equipment over there, and they can only carry by labor, you know, by man. So they have limited supply. Even if you have money, you have gold, you have diamond, you can't buy anything there. Yes. And then when you go to the toilet outside, your butt froze, that I don't tell you. Not only your butt froze, everything else come out of it froze too. I'm sorry, it's not a fun thing to do, huh? And when you hear some animal, oh, then you run. Yes, forget to put your pen up. Yeah. Yeah, talk about Himalaya. Don't romanticize too much about Himalaya, okay? And some of the so-called holy river along the side, oh my God, all kind of... No. Yesterday, chapatis digested all over everywhere. And you have to walk tiptoe everywhere, otherwise you step on everything. Yeah? That was the beautiful chapati yesterday, but the day after it became different. The smell different. It looks different. And it makes you feel different about it. And it's all over everywhere. You're the most beautiful, romantic riverside. You want to sit there, meditate. No. You don't find any place to even put your feet on. Okay? So that's the reality. Alright? Some of the places are more civilized. I mean, people stay around there. Where are some huts and some caves, the monks and all that, they stay there. Then it's more clean. But clean on that part, but on top of that, you don't know what flow down, you know. Anyhow, I drink it, it's okay, I'm still alive. But I don't know. I wouldn't go there, drink it again. I was blind. I was blind. You know, when you're in love, you're blind. I was absolutely in love with God. I fear nothing. I don't understand anything. I don't know anything. So I jump in the river and believe in that it will wash my sin. Yeah, if I have any sin at all, it will froze to death. My hair become like this. When I came out of the river, it stick everywhere, you know. Like ice stick, you know, icicle, popsicle, icicle, yeah. Yeah, I look a real yogi with all my hair stand out like that in different direction. Huh? It's awful? Yeah, it's ice water, what did you expect? Yeah, the way, because I walk, so I keep myself warm. I sweat. Yeah, I wear the thin pajama, just cotton pajama, that's it. And I was sweating. And everybody else walked on their horse, on other people's back, and they feel, my God, they think I'm a saint. They thought I was a saint. Yeah, in fact, one guy wanted to marry me because he think I was a saint. Yeah, yeah. The whole family fell in love with me. Mother tried to match me up for the boy. I sent to over him, and I'm married anyhow. You know, at that time, I was still married. Yeah. If you feel you don't have a husband here, just go to the Himalaya. And walk the way of love. Yeah. If you walk like I did, you know, men will come to you anytime. They want to take me home and take care. Many, they think I'm amazing. They think I'm a saint. They think I'm something. Yeah, I was so blind. It's really a sick, scary journey. I wasn't equipped. I just walked with one sleeping bag, two pair of pajama, and one pair of rotten sports shoes, which is soaking wet every day. Yeah, and my feet become red and swollen and all that, and I still walk like that every day. For months, you know. Sometimes you have a shelter, sometimes you don't. I must be blind or stupid. Huh? Yeah. Anyhow, you know, why do we talk about that? Scare you, huh?
Yeah.
I don't want to be responsible for your burial in Himalaya, so I have to tell you, yeah, for feeling afraid that my story about Himalaya, that I went there and get enlightened and get a master there, would tempt you to risk your life to go there. There's nothing they can give you there that I cannot give you here. There's nothing you have there that you cannot have here, okay? That's all I want to tell you. But if you want to go Himalaya, it's okay too. Yeah. You imagine a lot, I say, okay, we walk into the Himalaya and the spiritual master just appeared. And all light all over, you know. Yeah. I don't see any master appear, just see my hair sticking out. And my feet swollen. My shoes never dry. My shoes never be dry, but my socks never dry. Later I don't care anymore. Because being wet anyhow, whether I wear shoes or not. It's not as romantic as it seems. Yeah, okay.
Could you tell us a little bit about your master, the one that you found that initiated you into the Kuan Yin method?
What do you want to know, Mai?
I've heard a lot of them are quite old, with the age.
Yeah.
He's fairly old.
He is very old. He was old.
He was old.
Yeah. Anything else? He has a nose in the middle. Two eyes, Long Bear? All right? He was old. Yes, that one. Okay, what else? Right? What else? You satisfied? Okay. Yeah, so quiet. Okay, all right then. You have asked everything you ask? And all right, one more question and we go. Okay, you're cold? It's getting cold. No?
One thing I've enjoyed in other practices is chanting. What place does chanting take in your discipline here? It's like either like the Hare Rama short chants or like the Sri Guru Gita, which is a beautiful.
If you want to chant, then you meditate.
You chant want first, then
chant
meditate.
And meditate, or chant any time you want. It's all right.
But the chant's not dysfunctional. It's just.
No, that's okay.
Whatever puts you in the proper place.
Huh? Yes. You like to chant God's name, chant. Okay, chant with your heart. Can you chant as an offering? All right? Yes. But that is not enough. That's what I mean.
No.
Okay, yeah. You have to meditate on the light and the sound because that's you.
It's
that's
hard,
yourself.
It's hard to meditate when you're driving, so it's better to chant.
You repeat the name. Repeat the name of God. Yeah? Or you chant sometimes, okay. Nothing forbidden. But you better be more familiar with the five names in case you die suddenly, and then that's all that takes you. Okay? That's all that protects you in time of danger. You have to be acquainted to it until it becomes automatic. Alright? Not that when you have a car accident and your head bump into your steering wheel and you still, hallelujah.
Is there a chance it has five names in it?
I won't have
you
to.
I have to write it. No chance.
Recite
the
five names. You just chant it in your head, okay? Repeat it. Repeat it. I like a chanting. Chanting. Okay? Because that's what elevates you, alright? That's a real charging power, okay? It's not just a name, it's a charging power of initiation, okay? So use that. And recharge it and make it more powerful every day. So anything happen to you, you in God's hand. Understand? Alright guys? Okay? Thank you very much. Go home, meditate a little bit more at home, okay? Meditate a lot more. A lot more. Anytime you can, meditate, okay? Recite the holy names and pray for the world. Okay? Bye.